I think classifying the vitiligo or trying to quantify or morphologically identify where the disease stands is really important. I really try to think of my patients as either being unstable, meaning their disease is active and spreading, or stable, meaning it's been at least a year where they've just kind of had one area or two or three large areas that have not progressed. They're not getting new patches. It's just kind of stuck there. And then the recalcitrant patients would be the ones that have seen, you know, multiple other doctors before they come to see me, or tried other treatments, or are coming back to me after having been lost to follow-up for a while, whatever circumstance, but their disease, no matter what you do, is just not getting better. So those are sort of the three broad categories: unstable, stable, and recalcitrant. And then with those categories, I then try to quantify, if they are unstable, how much more is their disease spreading within a 4 to 6 week period? Is it one palm of their own body surface area, or so, you know, their own palm being 1% of their own BSA? Is that how much more they're getting? Are they getting small little confetti areas, which is a sign of active disease? Do they have trichrome disease, which is where there's three zones of color, and we're actually seeing more of that autoimmune attack of the skin right in front of our own eyes? So it really helps to broadly classify that.